Now we're here in front of Razorback Football Stadium, and now we learn that Fayetteville misses out nearly on $5 million each time the Hogs play in Little Rock.
It's no big secret. On a really good football game, we might do 25,000, 28,000 for the whole weekend if they're playing in town. If they're not, we might do 3,000 or 4,000 for the weekend.
David Odell, owner of Big Reds, misses a chance to make about $24,000 every time the Razorbacks don't play in Fayetteville. He says home games used to be played in Little Rock because the Fayetteville Stadium only held 43,000 people and War Memorial held 53,000. The Fayetteville Chamber of Commerce says that's not the case anymore.
That's the argument now. You've got one now that's got 70,000 and one that's got 50,000. It makes sense to stay in the bigger facility.
Fayetteville Chamber of Commerce tells 4029 News the city makes most of its money during Razorback home games, when up to 48,000 people come from out of town to watch the Razorbacks play. The Chamber says those visitors spend about $102 per person each day they're in town. That doesn't count meals and hotel fees. The owner of Big Red says Little Rock may be closer for some fans. The Fayetteville is the main attraction for Razorback football.
Fayetteville is the home of the Razorbacks. I think a home game should be played here, not in Little Rock and not in Dallas.
And the U of A athletic department tells us that tomorrow's game against the Sanford Bulldogs is the only game that will air on pay-per-view this season. Live in Fayetteville, Go Chaloka, 4029 News.
This weekend's Razorback game is still far from a sellout. War Memorial Stadium administrators say there are plenty of tickets available. While they won't give an exact number of seats, it may be as many as 10,000. They're expecting a lot of walk-up traffic on game day to help fill out the crowd.